Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video. I hope you guys had a good Thanksgiving, a good Christmas, and a nice start in the new year. I sure did, and to celebrate all these events, I wanted to fly the 777. I bought myself a few sceneries, including the upgrade price for version 3 of this airport of Chicago, as well as from X Aviation. Dubai series, so I decided to do a long haul from these two airports. Now, I do have a reason why I want to fly the 777, and not only because it is capable of this range and is a perfect connection to these two airports, but because of the new year and of all the celebrations going on in the past and being thankful for so many things, I wanted to thank X-Plane and Flight Factor, in this case Ramza specifically, for their efforts into making X-Plane to what it is today and to get me into this position I am in now. All the way back in X-Plane 9, I'm not sure when, but I'm pretty sure X-Plane 9 still lasted about 3 years, I think, or 2 or 3 years, as I started it before X-Plane 10 came out. That's when I started with X-Plane, that's when I started with flight simulation, and I started with X-Plane 9. I never had FSX or anything because, we were Mac users, so our only flight simulator opportunity was X-Plane at the time because it supported Mac. Fast forward to a year or two later, I started seeing all these people posting videos. I mean, even before I started flight simulation, I watched all these flight simulating videos and I was so impressed. I was like, I want to do that one day. Of course, I also want to do the real thing, and I still do, and I'm still pursuing it. But I also wanted to do flight simulation because I thought it was really cool, and it was the closest thing I could do at my age to actual flying. So for Christmas, or I think it was my birthday actually, I got X-Plane 9. I was so happy, and of course I knew nothing about flying, so I learned everything from X-Plane 9. So I really deeply want to thank Laminar Research, like all the developers, and especially Austin Meyer, for creating this platform for me to have an opportunity to be a part of this flight sim community. And then of course my very ever first payware aircraft was the 777. At that time, only the LR was available and it was a fresh release, so I bought it right off the press. And man, this aircraft, like, it's so much nostalgia behind this aircraft at the moment, for me at least. I'm like, incredible. It's incredible. It's, of course, very outdated if it came all the way back from X-Plane 9. But, it is still a great aircraft, and I'm so thankful for Flight Factor and Ramses, specifically for releasing this aircraft and putting the time into it to make X-Plane even better. And with all these add-ons we have today for X-Plane, it is just absolutely amazing, and I'm glad that Flight Factor has boomed to what it has become now, because they've developed incredible aircraft, and X-Plane 11 is just remarkable. So with this a million minute intro, let's get right into the pre-flight of this aircraft, because I want to do everything from scratch, just like I used to do it. Of course, now updated information, so I'm more knowledgeable now, so I try to do things a little more accurate now, but still, the nostalgia is still there. So let's get right into it. As you can see, it's getting kind of dark now, so I gotta hurry this up before it gets too dark. I'll start, make sure that the electrical is at its dead state, and we're gonna check one more thing here. That's this. I'm gonna drag it down here. I'm gonna hit load, and that's perfect. And go and open this door right here. Let's hope the perfect. So I think it wants the right one. I'm not sure. That's all weird on that one. So, make sure that the electrical is on dead state, battery's off, external power is off. But AP wouldn't even work at the time anyways. Exterior lights are all off. Speed brake is down to 10, which it is. Flaps are up. Door servers are now at idle. Fuel control switches are cut off. Battery can now come on. And we're running the BSS sound pack, of course. Make sure the hydraulics here are off. The electric hydraulics, the engine demand pumps are fine to be on. Wipers, make sure they're off. Gear is down. Alternate flaps right here is in the normal position and guarded. And we can now turn on the ground power units. So with that, we're going to go ahead and set up lighting. Normally, in order for the master brain to work, you would have set everything to this indent right here. And everything would function at the same time. But that's okay if it doesn't. Okay. I'm also going to do it here as well. There's going to be a few buggy textures, as you can see. Because I am running uppers, textures, and everything, as you probably can tell. But, yeah. Okay. Go and set our nav and level light. Because it is getting dark. That we can now do our payloads. So, number of passengers today we are about 335 passengers. Cargo weight, that's a good question. Cargo weight, we're at 22,448. APU time will leave, taxi time will leave, and takeoff fuel. Total fuel, we'll need 115,885 kilograms, which here is giving us 121. We actually want exactly that, so I'm going to estimate 109,114, and I'll do 110,000. 115,000, 315,800. Enter. And what does it need? Stairs and a fuel truck. And it probably needs to store. Okay, what else does it need? Passenger bus, of course. Alright, now it's loading. That ADIRU comes on. Make sure our IRS align. Take us about 9.5 minutes. Engine oil status. Make sure our oil quantities are good. And to your status, or actually the quantities are not right. Hydraulic quantities. We'll check. And oxygen. We'll check. Also, there's a bug where this depletes, which it should, but it's an old aircraft, so I'll cut it some slack. Go to the aft overhead, and we'll make sure that our cargo heat selectors are in at least the low, and if there is in the bulk, usually if there is a dog or any animal, set it to high. So we'll pretend there's a dog, so we'll set that to high, because 9 and 18 degrees Celsius is quite a big difference. Make sure our parking brake is set, and we'll copy the ADA, so we'll go and set VHF1, that is left and right. So 1 to 2 decimal. It's only a bad thing about. It's only a bad thing about this.
Kilo Oscar Romeo Delta Airport Information Echo 2151 Zulu Weather Wind 294 at 5 Visibility 10 Sky Condition Temperature 8 Dew Point minus 1 Altimeter 2967 Advice on Initial Contact You Have Information Echo Kilo Oscar Romeo Delta Airport Information Echo 2151 Zulu Weather Wind 294 at 5 Visibility 10 Sky Condition Temperature 8 Dew Point minus 1 altimeter 2 9.
Okay, 267 is set. We can now do do our MCDU. This would actually take a long time, so I think what I'm going to do, which I usually never do, is I'm just going to simply import the flight plan. GPS position. Go ahead and route request. Actually, we need to do Chicago. To OMDB. Route request. Okay. So it looks like we'll have to export it differently. Let's see how much information is it that we need to put in. A lot. Yeah, it'd be much simpler just to export it. So just give me a second here. I'll export it. In the meantime, we can go ahead and put in some information. We're going 28 right. Flight is United Emirates, UAE. 236, flight number. Okay, I'm also gonna. Sorry about that. Okay, about that. Go to PFPX, there we go, sorry about that. I'm going to. Export this. Now let's see if I can do this and not have to restart X-Wing, because that would be absolutely amazing. But it looks like I might have to. That's a real shame. It looks like we'll have to do everything manually. Alright. Well, I guess we'll do that then. It's gonna be a pain in the ass. But whatever. So departure, 128, third no SIDs for Chicago, because I don't know why, because they're stupid. okay. I'm going to do this. Can I extend this somehow? No. Of course not. Oscar Bravo Kilo. My Kilo Golf. Oh my goodness. Oh, Golf. Why does it keep going out? North 43. I believe it's north and west. Yes. Why? What? Oh, it's gonna make this so much more complicated than it has to be. Okay. Route. ASP. Mills. Number 6. Nope. 361 Bravo. November 31 Bravo. Azure. Now Nat Q. So Nat Type Q starts with 5050 North. North. Five, four, three, zero. Five, five, two, zero. Resno. Netgi. Liffy. Liffy is north. Now from Liffy. Uniform Lima 975. almost halfway there. Tell us. Lima 603. I don't think we have to put in the transition here. We'll try uniform Lima 603. Namzo. Ibiri. Tisca Osbit Camus Keems Amzi. East Pesat, or is it Pesat? No, that would be PSA. Pesat. Pesat. Tekri. Next page. Lima 605. Papa 975. Papa 975. Uniform Mike 688. Romeo 784. Bravo 416. I'm gonna make sure the waypoint is correct in that. Bravo 416. 416 is a mismatch. Bravo 416. No, that should be right. Oh. Okay. Romeo 748. Or 784, actually. Maybe it's 48. 748. No, that's. Romeo 784. Mismatch. Interesting. Where's our Romeo 784? Huh. Top Lima 223. Tip. And then we're gonna go ahead and enter our arrival as well. Probably change later or sooner or later. Tip 3 Bravo ILS 212 left by the zero transition that we're gonna use. Here we go, yes, heck. Alright. That took way too long. We'll now go to fix. Let's see, we'll have to check our departure charts. So I'm gonna go ahead and set those out here. So, Chicago, we just set our SID, SID, just the O'Hare 5, so runway 28 right will be during towards this direction, 4,000 feet, which is DME at GCO, so GCO at 9, we can expect 4,000 feet. We're going direct to. That's a good question. Legs. Oscar Bravo Kilo. Oscar Bravo Kilo. I don't see it anywhere. Mike Kilo Golf. To read departure, so runways 28 right centered or lower if authorized minimum climb to the, yes, we know that initial climb is 5,000. We I know our initial climb is now 5,000. Okay. Let's see if it. 5,000, we know that now. Alright, so cross DME. Also, I'm not able to comply by this. Turn left and just proceed direct to our route, which is fine. So let's go ahead and check our route. And actually, we will do not a fix. We'll do DME 5.5. So we'll do 5.5. We'll probably put it at. Yep. Okay. Delete this one. There's that one for 3,000. That's when we'll turn left. And we'll go to route, our legs, flight plan. Step through it. It's on the right. Okay, so we'll then turn right. Checking that our route does not have any weird indications. That looks good. Okay, did we just get a, yes, we did just got discontinuity. So we'll go ahead and enter that in. Voila. We've got a large part, so what we'll do is arrival and we'll get rid of. We'll just do ILS. Go back to route or legs, and we should be good now. Oh no, okay. Just do Ukraine. Okay. Move to out of. Alright, step through that, and that's perfect. Okay, activate, execute the changes. Flight plan is now active. Go to init, and we'll now continue with the overhead scan. So everything here is set, guards closed, everything is good to go. Emergency headlights arm, window heat coming on. Hydraulics are good, seatbelt signs coming on. Do a test here. That is checked. Shell light extinguishes. Perfect, normal auto, everything here is good, window heat. So everything's good, light test. Okay, that is good. Just wait till everything, there we go. Auto on, everything is set, packs coming auto. Everything here is fine, perfect. Now we'll go over here. Light director's coming on, auto throttle coming on. Bank limiter will go and set to 25. Make sure the disengage bar is up. Alright, check his oxygen. Only works with the thing, with the pumper. Okay, altimeter, make sure everything's checked and set. Everything here is checked. Reset that, although that it's linked, so not much we can check here. We'll just make sure everything is good here. This is on auto, auto brake coming RTO. Is fine, make sure our computer selector, oh, we already checked that right there. Alright, everything here is good, ultra flaps, all of that is good to go. Ta-da. Yep, left VHF is set, everything here is good, set that there. Center is fine, good to go, set this to auto. I will go ahead and close our door now. Right, rail trim free and zero. Nothing needs to be said here. There's not. I mean, there is usually tests in a rail plane, but not here. So 2001 evac test is checked, and this thing's been set to normal. There we go. Alright, captain's side. This is EFS, so we reset. this will set up to Vero anyways. Flight path vector VOR are tuned. Traffic is set. Airport data. And that is good to go. Okay. Now we do our oxygen test here as well. Are they looking at any chance? Yes, they are. Okay. I'm sure V2, the oxygen mask and everything here will look pretty much similar to this and will actually be functional. So let's hope for that, and I can't wait. Those V-speed, TCAS off is totally normal. Make sure our ground speed is zero. Toga, that's checked. Flight director is checked. We're good there. Flight plan has been checked as well. Standby instrument and ILS, everything here is also set, and our altimeter is set here as well. That's important. Make sure this is on normal, and this is set as well as required. Alright, we'll now do our pre-flight checklist. Oxygen test 100%, flight instruments heading approximately north 003 times 3 set, checked, and altimeter is set 3 times as well, 267, parking brake is set, and engine fuel control switches are cut off. Pre-flight checklist is completed. We can now start our APU. Depot sign is already on, external power will be coming off in just a moment. Go back to status. You can see our APU here starting up fairly quickly. Of course, it is a very old bird. Very old simulation, so I'm expecting realism right now. Okay, secondary and primary coming off. Packs are auto, that is checked. We can now disconnect our external connections here, so get rid of all of this. We'll even get rid of the shocks, this and that, close the door, and then once the door is closed, we'll check through the doors, go to manual, and now it's automatic, that is checked. Let's make sure one more time. Perfect. It's already starting to get dark. Unfortunately, a lot of calling ants. But that's alright as well. You know, it's been there since like 6.11, 9, so yeah. And we now finish our FMC. So, request performance here. Gross weight, really heavy. Our reserves today. Reserves today are, so our airport plus any alternate fuel, so final reserves 3.3 plus, nope, sorry, yes, 3.3 plus 3.3, that's 4 and 5, so 9 reserves are 9 today. Initial cruise altitude 290, ICAO size 2000. Okay. Cost index will be 65. It's efficient fuel. That's probably incorrect. Probably have a huge tailwind. I'll have to look. Average tail of 43 knots. Yeah, so that's going to be incorrect. Our 34 and takeoff, regular takeoff, D rate 103.5. Pretty huge. Flaps 15 today, CG is 24. So thrust acceleration will be 3,000 and thrust reduction 1,500. Noise abatement departure procedure 1. V1 is 167, 175, and 181. 17181 here. And LM mean up to not are not going to be engaged. Our heading does not show. So legs from between right is not right either. So I'm gonna set our heading here. It is about 2873. Okay. Take a page, and that is checked. Speeds, by the way, come on. Now go to proc progress as well. Just want to check a couple a little bit of data here. 93 nautical miles, sensor 7.9. That's probably going to be incorrect because we have a huge tailwind. Okay. Alright, let's go ahead and request pushback. Although, to be fair, I don't think better pushback works, so we need to do a straight pushback. If we can. Actually, no. We'll have to use this plugin here to push. Okay. I'll get ready here. Some hydraulics. Right electric. Temperature 8, there's no visible moisture, so no anti-ice required either. Recall. Check. Alright. And our trim 6.25. It's about 6.25. Okay, that's set. Trim is set. 4 start checklist. Take doors closed and lock passenger sensor auto and on. MCP V2 is 181, heading 273, initial altitude 5000. Takeoff speed set, V1 167, 175, and 181. Procedure briefing completed, fuel set tons 115.8. Restrict, trim is 6.25 units and 0.0. Check, takeoff and taxi tail briefing completed, beacon light is on. Set her into engine display. Let's go ahead and start our pushback. Spawner to TA only. And we can now push back, so let's go ahead and do a little bit of thrust here. Of course, actually, you know what? Reduce thrust, probably break off first. Start pushing back. See it moving. So, 2/8 right is right here. Very short. How unfortunate with the crawling ants, because then it would look even better. Might as well turn up the brightness of the cabin as well. Parking brake. Now start engine number 2. Now we have to, never mind, we have to wait till the pushback truck is gone. I think now. Okay, we see a bit increase, so set to run. before I started. Almost there. So I need number one. There's a Turan. So we'll start it here as well. Successfully start version 1 APU coming off. Go and check. Need flaps 1, we're actually 5, I believe. 10, no, 5, 15 now. Flaps up to 15. Go check flight controls. Full right, full left, control, full up, full down, control, full left, full right. Check is completed. And now the forward taxi checklist. NTS setters required, recall check, under Vegas RTO, flight controls are checked, and ground equipment is clear. Okay. So taxi light coming on. We're going to start our clock. Released. And here we go. So we're pretty much ready for departure, and the radar is set to on. Flaps are set 15. Engine display is blanked. Checklist is completed. We'll quickly do it before takeoff. Flaps and cabin ready. It's checked, now blanked. Transponder set to TARA. Perfect. And we're clear for takeoff, so what's coming on? Thrust sets up to 50%. I'm not sure what the Togo button is. So I'm just gonna, I think it's accept. I don't know, so I'm just gonna press the actual Togo buttons. two, three.